Welcome! Today we want to become familiar with all the necessary steps to create a very simple model, analyze it, and post-process the results using MSC.Patran and MSC.Nastran. After opening Patran, we are going to create a new database. So we go to File, New Database, select the folder we want everything saved at, and the name is going to be piston.db. We select OK and then make sure the analysis type is structural and the model dimension is 10. So now we already have the model for this, and we're just going to import a parasolid XMT. When the summary pops up, we click OK. And the next step is to create the material. So we'll go to Properties, Isotropic, and the material name is going to be steel. Now we have to input the properties. So the elastic modulus is 36 and the Poisson ratio is 0.3. We click Apply. Now we're going to create the solid. The set name is going to be piston, and we have to input the properties such as the material, which will be the steel we just recently made. We have to select the application region, the entire piston, add OK, and apply. Now we'll create the boundary conditions, starting by the displacement. The new set name for this is fixed. We have to input data as well. So in the translations slot, we'll enter 0, 0, 0, which means there won't be any rotation in any of the axes. We have to select the geometry entities. In this case, this is going to be both the pinholes. We have to add each one. Then select OK and apply. Now we have the constraints. Now we're going to apply a pressure of 1200 psi. We go to Element Uniform Pressure. The new set name for this is going to be piston underscore pressure. We'll input the data as well, so 1200. Okay, select application region. We have to select the top face of the piston. We add it, and then okay, and apply. Now we're going to create the mesh. Since we only have the student's license, we can only create a TET4 solid mesh, which is what we're going to do right now. The input list is the entire piston, and it's not going to be automatic. The global edge length must be 0.5. Now we'll apply, and we're ready to analyze. We're going to run an entire model full run analysis. We have to make sure the job name is the same as the database. We'll select the default subcase, and in output requests, we want to make sure that this is selected. Okay, apply. Now we're ready to analyze. Now Nastran is running the analysis. And we're now going to attach the results. We'll select the piston job. And apply. Now we can go to the results tab and select a quick plot. The fringe result must be stress tensor and the deformation result must be translational. And here we go. We wanted to determine if the stress in this typical piston model is low enough for the material to be in the linear elastic region. This means that the stress it's under can be taken off and the piece will return to its original shape. Here we can see that the stress is well below the limit, so it's in the linear elastic region. We can also animate these results. Here we can see the critical areas that are under the maximum stress and deformation. So, thanks for watching.